Good evening and welcome to Your Call. Joining me on the show tonight is a man who's truly lived a life less ordinary. Someone who came from a small village in Bihar, then went to Gorakhpur in eastern Uttar Pradesh, but now has an empire which is across India. In fact, it's the second largest employer after Indian Railways. A man who's seen it all, glamour and controversy. Joining me tonight is Sahara Shri Subrotha Roy. Thank you very much for coming in tonight, sir.
Thank you for calling.
Services to hotels, real estate, but I think you're glad one business you're not in right now is aviation. Your comments, sir, somebody who's been there, perhaps one of the only Indians who's made a profit out of aviation when you sold Air Sahara. What's going on now?
I tell you, basic problem is somewhere else. We should address that. There's no calculation of demand and supply in our country as far as aviation is concerned. Why did we just get out of it? The day it was decided that it will be open sky policy, I went to the aviation minister. I said, you want low cost airlines, give us, we'll do it. Don't add airlines, then it will be big fight, because everybody would like to have 20, 30, 40 aircraft, and it will be further deteriorate the bottom line. So I requested. He said, no, it is not possible. Okay, look, in India there is no low-cost airlines. It's a low-priced airline. The cost is the same. Major costs all are same. So, but he said that it has been decided. I can't help it. That was the evening I took a decision that I should come out of it, because unless there is demand and supply properly calculated, you see, in airlines, if three airlines starting from one destination to another destination in 5 minutes gap, you'll see maybe three together is one aircraft load, and it's all perishable seats, and but the cost is high.
You're talking only about aviation, or you're
not only aviation,
telecom,
in general,
other sectors
in general
as well.
You see, in financial this thing, I can tell you today, any bright candidate in India, a bright boy in India in young age, now he cannot make a big organization unless he's son of a big rich organization. They have closed down every possibilities.
Are you talking from personal experience? Because you were a young, bright boy from Gorakhpur.
Yes, I tell you, if you give me this today, the chance to again start, the things, the way it has been all banned, I won't be able to do it. No young entrepreneur can do this in the country anymore. No. We cannot reach to this level.
Why did they suddenly go after your non-banking financial services? Do you think there was some element of political persecution?
It was. But I'll request you not to ask beyond that.
From the UPA, from the Congress?
In appropriate time, I will come out with this story. And we were 100% right. Till today, we claim, challenge the government if they can raise one finger against us, that we had gone wrong, we are against the law, we did not do well in the business, we lose anything. It was a whimsical thing. It was a decision which anybody, if goes in details, they will just laugh and surprised.
I think the big surprise, of course, is when you signed that check, one check, and paid off 4 years in advance of what the RBI had asked you to pay your liability. But let's go across some questions from Lucknow and some people from there to ask you questions. Let's go ahead.
There is a question to you, Mr. Subrotha Roy. It is generally being said and perceived that you have been politically inclined to all the right kind of political parties everywhere, including the state and the center. I would like to ask whether this kind of thing has actually benefited you, and at the same time, have we also suffered because of this kind of extremely perceived political alignments?
You see, we are not friendly to any political party. We are friendly to the individuals, irrespective of their parties. It happens. We are human beings.
You heard Akhilesh Yadav swearing in. Doesn't that send out a signal that you're close to Samajwadi Party?
Oh yes, I really love that boy. He's such a good person. I know him from childhood. Yes, I was there. I will be there. As a person, not party. I have nothing to do with any party. And we have nothing to do with any party. But individually, we have every right to be friends with the right people.
But usually you will find that in India, the whole, what people would say is the nexus between businessmen and politicians is because of the benefit that in politicians, no business can move without a political clearance. So businessmen have to be friends with politicians.
I'm really not friends to the people for the benefits. Then in that case, I go to the people where the benefits are there. They're acquaintances. I go with the business, with my certain reasons and problems or whatever. I'm not friend to the people just to get the support. I'm friend to the people irrespective of support or no support. And I can tell you one thing. If you ask all these political people who are known to me or are close to me, hardly I've gone to them for any support unless it is legitimate support. Mm-hmm. I have never gone to one person in this country, any political person, to get any favor, license or anything. I've not done it. And I don't believe in that.
Subrat Rai ji, मेरा आपसे ये सवाल है कि आपके सहारा फाइनेंशियल और OFCDs को लेके कई कंट्रोवर्सीज जनरेट हुई जिसके कारण आपको फेज आउट भी करना पड़ा. यहाँ तक कि सुप्रीम कोर्ट भी आपके इस मॉडल को लेके हैरान थी और इसकी जांच सेबी को दी गई है. मेरा आपसे ये पूछना है कि आपके बिजनेस मॉडल में मॉडल इतना कॉम्प्लेक्स क्यों होता है, इसमें ट्रांसपेरेंसी इतनी ज्यादा क्यों नहीं है और ये सस्पिशियस क्यों लगता है लोगों को?
आपने हमसे पूछा कि ऐसी बातें क्यों होती है कि RBI सेबी और वो एक कॉन्ट्रोवर्सी बनी रहती है और चीजें सामने नहीं आती है. उसके पीछे कई कारण है. आज सुप्रीम कोर्ट की बात कर लो, कोर्ट्स की बात कर लो, कानून में हम लोग 100% सही हैं. हर आदमी समझ रहा है. अगर ऐसा नहीं होता तो 2 साल से कोर्ट में केस नहीं होता, कब का खत्म हो गया होता. प्रॉब्लम है हम लोग के साइज. उन सबको एक परेशानी हमारी साइज. अगर ये छोटा साइज होता अब तक हमारे फेवर में कब का डिसीजन आ चुका होता. हर आदमी सोच रहा ओ इट्स अ बिग साइज. हां, आज हमारे 10 लाख लोग काम कर रहे हैं, 4036 हमारे एस्टैब्लिशमेंट्स हैं. साइज हैज टू बी बिग. मैं इन लोगों से एक रिक्वेस्ट करूंगा यहां से कि साइज को आप देखें, रेगुलेट करें उसको, नए नए कानून बनाए उसको, अच्छा कंट्रोल करें और कंट्रोल के और नए नए एस्पेक्ट सामने ला दे. मगर उसको बंद करना चूंकि साइज बड़ा है, ये गलत है, देश के लिए अच्छी बात नहीं है. वो बंद करने के जो ये लोग कर रहे हैं, जो एकदम एक तरफा बायस्ड होकर कर रहे हैं कुछ डिपार्टमेंट्स, मैं ये कहूंगा दे आर एक्टिंग अगेंस्ट द कंट्री. उन्होंने सारा ब्लॉक कर दिया यंग एंटरप्रेन्योर्स का.
बिकॉज यू मेड दैट पॉइंट ऑल्सो, डेली डिपॉजिट, दो स्कीम्स जो शट डाउन बाय द सुप्रीम कोर्ट, इज वन ऑफ योर मोस्ट पॉपुलर स्कीम्स. यू हैड लिटरली डेली वेज लेबरर्स यूज टू इन्वेस्ट देयर मनी इन द चिट फंड. बट द इश्यू अगेन ऑन वेयर द सोर्स ऑफ सहारा परिवार, वेयर डू द फंड कम फ्रॉम, वाई आर ऑलवेज सो मेनी क्वेश्चंस आस्क्ड अबाउट द मनी the Sahara group has.
Actually, जैसे daily की बात, you are talking about the daily accounts. We are still having daily accounts. We are running daily accounts in cooperative. My workers have developed the cooperative after the RBI thing. And daily accounts still there. I tell you, daily accounts is a financial inclusion for this country. Because we are maybe having around 2.5 crores of depositors who are in the daily accounts. Those are the people, the cobblers, the tea wala, the thela walas, and all those kind of people, rickshaw walas. They are banks, though, don't go. They don't go to bank. We should be appreciated for this. I think the system should learn to appreciate first. It is a financial inclusion.
We do have somebody, an Uttar Pradesh politician who's actually been in the SP, BSP, and currently in the Congress, Kazim Ali Khan, to ask you a question.
You know, I was in the Samajwadi Party as well between 2004 and 2007. And at that point of time, it was very much in our party circles that, you know, the party had obliged you in properties between Noida and Greater Noida, you know, was that true?
If there is only one case, I will lose anything in my life. If there is only one case, forget about giving land, etc. One case if you get, I will lose anything.
But you've heard the rumors, the political rumors, people who will say that, oh, Sahara Shree's money comes from Mulayam Singh Yadav and the Samajwadi Party. What do you say to
them? I think, to my knowledge, Mulayam Singh ji and family must not have investment a rupee in our company. Not a rupee value. Maybe somebody, 10,000, 15,000 and 1 lakh, somebody has deposited in some name, I do not know. Mm-hmm. Because there are 8.5 crores of depositors. Mm-hmm. But I can tell you, I have gone through the figures, 98% of our depositors are, average deposit is 12,000, 13,000 rupees. Only 1% may be having 5 lakhs, 7 lakhs, 10 lakhs. Mm-hmm. Not, to my knowledge, and I'm sure what I'm saying is right, not a single rupee has come from their family ever. And this much, 10-20 lakhs if somebody has put somewhere in some branch, I do not know. Mm-hmm. But beyond that is my challenge to the system. If they find anything of that sort, as the people talk about, they can hang me. I can challenge. I am challenging the system.
What's so remarkable about your journey is where it began. And it began from a small village in Bihar. And I have some questions from there for you tonight.
आप बड़े बड़े टूर्नामेंट करवाते हैं, क्रिकेट के टूर्नामेंट करवाते हैं, खेल के लिए जो आपका लगाव है वो अररिया जिला वासियों के लिए क्यों नहीं है? आप तो यहाँ के, आपका ये जन्मस्थली रह चुका है और यहाँ ऐसे स्टेडियम, आप स्टेडियम का निर्माण क्यों नहीं करवाते हैं जिससे कि यहाँ के बच्चों का प्रतिभा उभर कर सामने आ सके और वो उस स्तर पे जाके अपना प्रतिभा को दिखला सके जहाँ की धोनी जैसे खिलाड़ी खेल के अपने प्रतिभा को लोगों को सहानुभूत करते हैं।
अररिया एक ऐसा जगह है, मैं तो बचपन से वहीं पर रहा हूँ, तो अररिया ऐसा जगह, वहाँ स्टेडियम नहीं बन सकता।
Did you play cricket there? Did you when you were a small boy?
Football there more. But वहाँ पर स्टेडियम अगर बना भी दिया जाए ना तो वो खाली रहेगा हमेशा। हाँ, एक चीज मैं जरूर करूंगा, मैंने अभी डिक्लेयर भी किया था कि 16 स्पोर्ट्स सेंटर्स बनाएंगे। चलो आज मैं अररिया के लोगों के लिए यह कहना चाहता हूँ, अररिया में एक स्पोर्ट्स सेंटर जरूर बनाएंगे। स्पोर्ट्स हॉस्टल बनाने जा रहे हैं हम लोग, वो बनाएंगे, उसमें प्रतिभाएं सामने आ सकती है, स्टेडियम से नहीं आ सकती। Sports hostel jayegi.
And of course, we've seen the Subrata Roy Stadium in Pune for Pune Warriors. Many people asked, why did you name the stadium after yourself?
मैं छह महीने तक रोकता रहा BCCI को, जो मेरे नाम से नहीं होना चाहिए। It's very embarrassing, very embarrassing. छह महीना मैंने अलाउ नहीं किया, तब उन लोगों ने अपना रूल बुक से निकाल के दिया कि किसी भी कॉरपोरेट नेम से स्टेडियम नहीं बन सकता है BCCI रूल के हिसाब से, इट कैन बी ओनली ए पर्सनल नेम। छह महीना फाइट करने के बाद मैंने सबको रिक्वेस्ट किया जो प्लीज आप इसको चेंज करो रूल को, दे कुड नॉट, अल्टीमेटली आई टू एक्सेप्ट। इट इज वेरी एम्बेसिंग, बिलीव मी इट इज एम्बेसिंग। I didn't want it.
All right.
If you ask anybody from the BCCI, they will say so many times it was discussed in the meeting that this man doesn't want.
Okay.
But I had to accept it.
I mentioned that bit about your wife and what a strength she's been, that you even sold her jewelry at one point. And your wife joins us tonight, Swapna Roy. And ma'am, so many years with Mr. Subrata Roy.
Hi,
I'm sure.
How are you?
Hi, I'm fine.
But about the gold you said, na, I will tell her something. In her presence. Yes, I sold her gold, that's true. And then my psychology became such. Any time, birthday, anniversary, I used to purchase gold for her. And after a few years, she says, stop it. Now gold jewelry's days are gone. You think something else also as a gift. I used to just compensate. That was my psychology, yes, I used to do that.
I heard, in fact, that Mr. Subrata Roy used to write you many, many, many letters. Is that true? Is he a good writer?
Yeah, I still.
I'll say something on this.
I still have the letters with me. I still have them with me.
I'll say something.
I cherish them.
Actually, I was not good in English at all, and she was very good. She was always a topper in the university, gold medalist, etc. So she used to write in English. So ego thing was there. I used to also write, but she used to write 2 pages, I used to write 10 pages. The one day after marriage, in the evening when I came back, she was having all the letters on the bed. I said, my wife is so romantic today. I said, what is this romance? What is it? Well, no, it's something else. I want to correct in English. I was thinking since long time that I should sit with your letters so that I can correct your English.
Mrs. Roy, is that true? That's very unromantic of you.
Ask her.
You know, To some extent, yes, but I have kept the letters. They are still there with me. I've kept them very carefully and they are very precious to me.
Thank you. Thank you so much for joining us tonight. Thank you. It was wonderful having you on the show.
Thank you.
That's a fair point, but we have some questions now from Pune as well to ask.
Subrata uncle, you must have missed Yuvraj Singh. You have to promise us that next year he will play for Pune and make us win.
Another very special guest joining us is Yuvraj Singh. And Mr. Roy, we just heard those Pune fans saying, promise us you bring Yuvraj Singh back to play next year. What would you say to that fan?
Well, it depends on the doctor's advice. I will not allow UV to come on the ground unless doctor says go. I'm waiting for that time, that day. But even if you ask UV, he will say, I'll go tomorrow. But we will not allow as a guardian. Hi, UV. How are you?
Namaste, sir. Sara Pranam. I'm good, sir. How are you?
I'm fine.
Tell us, as somebody who's really become a role model for so many other people, I think you've gained so many more fans, so many more admirers by the way, the moral strength, the mental strength you've shown during this whole ordeal. Tell us how Yuvraj Singh has changed as a person, as a cricketer.
Well, I just, I don't know about the changes. There's been a lot of changes happened to me and my body, but I've learned a lot through this while. There's been a lot of support from India, through the fans, from Sarashi, and it's been really overwhelming. Mm-hmm. I've been awestruck by that. And that is one of the reasons that I've come back so strong. I was, giving my messages back home that I'm strong and I'm going to go through this. So it was important for me to spread a message, people who are going through such diversity in life, that they also come out strong and fight this disease.
But you must be going through highs and lows as well. You just got the Sports Illustrated Man of the Year, and you said at that function that, who knows whether I'll play cricket again. How do you battle what must be the optimism, your natural optimism and strength, and often sometimes the depression and the worries that must be coming to you? How do you battle this?
Obviously, last year was tough because I was really struggling in the World Cup and IPL after that. But after my diagnosis, it's been really hard for, my family and friends. We obviously are not in great of shape or in good mental state at that time. But you see a lot of people around you who are also feeling really bad for you and they want you to get well, but it's unfortunate whatever happened, but strong all this while. I wanted to come back and play. Coming and playing for India and obviously for Pune was my dream. And unfortunately, after the third cycle, my body was really weak, so I could not come back and play in this IPL.
Mm-hmm.
But hopefully in the coming months, as my body gets stronger, as I train really hard, it's going to be very hard, to come back. I have to train maybe a couple of hours extra to regain the strength.
Hopefully I can do that in the
next couple of months and shine for my country again.
But just final words from you tonight. What would you like to tell all your fans who are watching this show? And really, what's the one thing or what's touched you the most in all these last months as you've battled cancer and come back?
Obviously, at tough times, as I said, there's been a lot of support from my country. I've seen little kids going to temples and a lot of people from
other parts of India going
and praying for me. Even elders, I've seen on wheelchairs going and
signing a picture to the message that we get back
soon. So,
I want to thank everybody from the bottom of my heart for
their support. Hopefully with their wishes again, I can come back and play for India. I just want to thank Sarashi for all this love and support.
Yuvraj, thanks very much. Mr. Roy, would you like to say something as we say goodbye to Yuvraj tonight?
Yuvi, I love you. You know that.
Love you too, sir. Thank you very much.
Yuvraj, thank you so much for joining us tonight. Thank you.
Thank you, Sonia.
Between Yuvraj and Saurabh, is it fair to compare?
Yesterday I was talking to my son. I said, look, now whatever this situation is, because we never got an open auction. We joined later. Na.
Mm-hmm.
We are the only team today. We were not in the open auction. So our Indian players particularly, we could not get something very strong. And this guy was very strong, UB. He's not there. So that is our problem from the last year only. As far as Saurabh is concerned, there is nothing like that. I was talking to my son. I said, give now new players chance who are sitting. They should also get opportunity. You are losing or whatever. I am not thinking on the losing or winning. But I am really now, I want the remaining matches. All the good players, some Indian players, some foreign players, they did not get chance ever. They request all the seniors to take some rest and they should get chance.
One unanswered question is always about what happened with Amar Singh.
You see, it's not only Amar Singh, I will talk in general. Many persons they achieve, he also achieved a lot. But some person they cannot keep that cool, that maybe the level, in the sense, level in the sense.
You get carried
you should,
away.
You get carried away. I think everybody, well, I'm, by the grace of God and blessing of God, I have not faced that. But I have seen many, many people, they have a phase where they lose the that has happened with him also. And he did all the mistakes. Good human being. Is a phase. It was a phase. And it, this phase came after they were in the power in Uttar Pradesh. So, I'll put it this way, that God has some formula, system, planning for everybody. He gives certain thoughts to somebody which works just the reverse, the way it should work. So I think he was victim of that.
Finally, sir, as we end, so many controversies, so many questions, and of course many have asked Sahara Shri, Sahara Parivar, Sahara Pranam. We just saw Yuvraj and you also do Sahara Pranam. What's behind all this? Why is it a bit of megalomania? What the Sahara Subroto Roy Stadium, why are you obsessed with yourself in a sense?
No. When we go to temple, we offer flowers and agarbatti, etc. Go to masjid, we go for namaz. Go to church for the prayer. That binds you emotionally, that community. It's always nice to be a family community. And there should be common thing of greeting, of uniform. Why army has uniform? This is one community for a purpose. So, of course, this influence is of my NCC and army. This influence is out of my NCC. That uniform, greetings. This is all I believe, strongly believe, it has really worked well. It binds you emotionally very well. It really binds you emotionally. Like, when we go outside India, we do namaste. Immediately we become friends. Only namaste. That is the common greetings we have. So these things work very well emotionally.
Subroto Roy, thank you so much.
I am happy to get this opportunity on the word controversy. That I challenge the entire government of India. I challenge them. Entire government of India. If they can find out one thing, then in last 32 years Sahara has done against anything, against law or the spirit of law. Law is a very technical thing. There is this reason behind the law. If against spirit of law, if one thing they can come out with, if they can come out with one case that Sahara has done a black money business, 1 rupee, if they can come out with that 1 rupee you have earned out of this license bhaji and manipulation of the government, or anything against values and the ethics, we are all ready to get hanged. We are all ready to get all punishments. But my request to the government of India will be, in the interest of the country, that if that some company is going like this, they should have all the appreciation, and the people who are creating problem for us, they should be hanged and they should be punished.
I think strong words to end the program with tonight. I'm glad you expressed yourself there, Mr. Subroto Roy, and thank you so much
for joining us tonight. Thank you, sir.